Europa Oil and Gas has just announced that it's been awarded a conditional award of a license in a block in the southern part of the North Sea, just off the Yorkshire coast. Well, the CEO, Hugh MacKay, is on the line now and is going to tell us all about it. Hugh, this was actually, and we've talked a lot in the past about various projects you're aiming towards, but this one is a bit of a well-kept secret.
Yes, we made the application in the 28th round, and we didn't draw any attention to the fact that we'd made some applications. We don't always, whilst it's no secret, we're bidding in the 14th onshore round and the Atlantic margin round offshore Ireland. You know, other applications we choose not to draw attention to. And in this case, we had to wait until the second tranche announcement yesterday for the award to be made. So it's nice that the rabbit has finally come out of the hat and hopefully given our investors a pleasant surprise.
Well, so why did you take a speculative punt, if you like, on this one? What's in it for you? You know, what appealed to you about it? What expertise have you got in the area?
Well, Europa previously held the license as a traditional license in the 21st round and had been focusing on there are some Permian gas discoveries on the license that were made in the late 60s and 70s that had quite good flow rates of gas from the Platin dolomite, but they weren't sustained, and it was eventually concluded that the Platin dolomite wasn't weren't commercial volumes of gas. But as a consequence of that, we've got a very, very good technical data archive. But really, we're applying onshore and some of the recent developments in the onshore to the offshore, particularly looking at the Carboniferous prospectivity. You know, right next to the coast, for example, there's the Cloughton gas field north of Scarborough, which is a tight gas sand, and there is potential for other Carboniferous prospectivity in the offshore that might be, it's in comparatively shallow water. It may actually be easier to drill and quicker and easier to drill using an offshore rig than trying to do it with an onshore to offshore drilling. But both the conventional and I suppose the new ideas from unconventional prospectivity may have applications in the offshore. And this license is an area that we can start to apply the knowledge that we've gained over the last two or three years in the onshore UK.
So really, the next 2 years, because it's a conditional license, the next 2 years are going to give you a chance to test this new hypothesis about, and this new approach about what you might find that's useful in the area.
That's correct. We've got 2 years to effectively build up the prospectivity story and find a farming partner. And it's comparatively low cost. It is looking at possibly doing some seismic reprocessing or purchase of existing data. So it's of the order of tens of thousands of pounds of expenditure. So we can manage our financial exposure and focus on bringing in a farming partner and then converting to a traditional license, which would carry more substantial commitments. So in that sense, it's very much like the promote licenses offshore Ireland. And the other event that might help us is, we understand that the 14th round, some of the blocks anyway, might be announced over the next 2 weeks. Well, that was in the Sunday Times a couple of weeks ago.
So that could be a surprise for you that you weren't expecting.
Well, not only that, there's the licenses that we might be awarded, but it'll also be very interesting to see who the new players are in the onshore UK. And certainly some of those new players might be interested in what's going on in the kind of near offshore. So those are all sort of positive developments, I think. And certainly if you're looking to drill and stimulate a well, it would be much easier doing it offshore than onshore.
Yeah, so it looks like August could well be not a quiet month, but actually could be quite interesting. But I just want to look at your strategy, Rick, because you have a small number of diverse projects on the go. I suppose the key to using them effectively and getting the cost effectively is to make sure that you have, in effect, a decent pipeline of different projects at different stages. Are you happy that that plan is going well?
Yes, it is. We've got the pipeline is beginning to bear fruit, I suppose. We've got the Wessel discovery in Pedal 180 that we've just finished one extended well test on the Peniston, and that when I was interviewed by Juliet a couple of weeks ago, that's provided a positive surprise, if you like, 182 barrels of oil equivalent per day from the Peniston flags, and we're now moving on to test the Ashover, and that's a project that we could bring on to production comparatively quickly. There is a decision coming up imminently on the Holmwood Pross planning inquiry in the Weald Basin. We were promised that was, according to the bespoke program, that's coming on or before the 7th of August, which if they stick to it, that's next week. And that's a project which is drill ready. The next logical step there is drilling it. Depending on what we get in the 14th round, there are projects there that we can start to fast track towards drilling. And the nice thing about conventional oil and gas projects in the onshore UK is that they can, in the event of success, they can be fast tracked to production comparatively quickly. Whereas offshore Ireland, where the prizes are potentially 1,000 times bigger, but the sort of flash to bang time to drilling takes longer because the scale of investment is much larger, with wells costing of the order of $60 to $100 million,
and of course,
to onshore UK, where well costs are the order of $3 to $5 million. So it's a different scale of investment and a different scale of reward.
But you've still got coming up in September, I think it is, that the Irish awards process.
The Irish license round closes in September, and then we're hoping that the awards will be made in the first half of next year, and it will be really interesting, one, to see what we get, and we're planning on making multiple applications. And whilst we hope that we're going to be successful, we also hope that there might be some interesting new players coming into the basin who will bring sort of energy, financial resources and excitement into the basin.
All right. Hugh MacKay, thank you very much indeed for joining us.
Thank you.